Shanghai GDG is a very interesting developer community.
I'm glad somebody has asked this question.
This is where the magic happens.
This is primarily a question and answer show. So if any of you out there would like to ask questions.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Google Developers Live. I'm Claudio, and this is Alan. We're two engineers in the Google Drive developer relations team. Today, we're going to talk about an application that integrates with Drive and that is available on the Chrome Web Store that allows you to do image editing on the cloud. We're actually going to show you two separate applications from the same producer. The two applications are called Pixlr Editor and Pixlr Express. As you can easily imagine, Pixlr Editor is more powerful. Pixlr Express can be used to do quick editing to your images. But let's see how they work. Let's move to the screen. I just downloaded an important wallpaper for my computer from freewallpapersweb.com.
Everybody needs a wallpaper.
Yeah, everybody needs a wallpaper. So let's see. I have this beautiful image on my Google Drive account. This is, of course, work-related. And I need to do some editing. So I just clicked on the file, and it opened in the Google Drive default viewer. But I previously installed this application called Pixlr Editor. So I can, instead of opening the application from here, I can do Open With and select Pixlr Editor.
We can do it from here, or we can do it back from the Google Drive web UI.
Exactly. And of course, Drive filtered the list of applications that can open that file. So if you have many applications installed, but some of them open text files, some of them open images, and some of them can open other kind of files, of course, when you right-click on an image, you want to see the applications that can actually open images. And Pixlr Editor and Pixlr Express are two of those. So let's start with Pixlr Editor, which is very, very powerful. So when we click on a file, the image gets loaded into this web interface. And as you can see, we have a lot of features here. So some easy ones, you can obviously resize images. You can add some editing. You can make this image worse by drawing on it. Want to try something?
Want to draw something?
Yeah. Let's see. I don't know. The sun. Can you draw
sun?
It? Oh, yeah. Oh, the black sun. That's really creepy. So Alan is definitely. What is that? Okay. That's gonna be my wallpaper for the future. Thank you, Alan. So as you can see, you have a lot of features here. So you have a number of filters you can apply. You have a lot of layers you can create. You can resize the image. You can make it bigger. You can draw on it. You can add text. You have gradients. Oh, what is that you're going to try now?
You can select.
Use a magic wand.
Yes.
Oh, great. I see you're very good at that. What else can you do?
Select this thing.
Okay, and now what?
I don't know.
Okay, well, you're definitely very good. So, I mean, there are actually people who can do something with graphic applications. Alan is not one of those. And is randomly pressing buttons. And what is that now? A filter. You're applying a filter. Why are you doing that?
Just trying the.
Okay, just trying that. Okay, let's say you made this image better. And you did that by adding a smile. Now we want to save back to Drive. Can we go back to real stuff?
All right.
Okay, let's see if we want to save back to Drive.
So we go to File, Save, and then we have the option to save to Drive. So we can save on the same image or make a copy.
Okay. And then you see this same application, Pixlr Editor, can save to a number of different online services. Of course, you can export it to your local computer. So you can have this JPEG file saved to your local computer and use it from there. But if you want to save it to Drive, you want to save it to Picasa, Flickr, and other social destinations, you can do all of that from here. So you save it. And one thing we notice, because we're going to focus more, of course, on the Drive integration, is that as a default, you're saving it as a copy. And if, of course, you can set the quality. What is the difference in saving as a copy or saving as a new file?
Well, in Drive, as opposed to our online file system, you can have many files with the same file name. Mm-hmm. So if you save it as a copy, you have two files named kittens.
I see. So let's see what happens. Let's save it as a copy. And then when that is done, we go back to Drive and see what we have there. And what we're expecting is to see two different images, one with a nice smile and one without. Right. And so let's see. Let's try to open one. We have two.
Open the first one.
And this is the original one. And this is actually good.
Open the enhanced one.
Okay. That's you also set a very low quality. I see. Obviously, Pixlr can do much better than this. You can select the quality you want, and I think you made a very bad choice.
No, I use the pixelate filter, so I try to do an 8-bit style.
I see. You're very good at that. Okay. This is Pixlr editor. There are some things we noticed that can be improved in the integration between Pixlr editor and Google Drive. So what we've seen so far is great. Of course, you can also create a new image from scratch from Google Drive by clicking on Create, More, and then you see the list of applications which can create file, including Pixlr editor.
That's cool.
So when we start from there, you can create a new image, you can open an image from your computer, and so on. Let's say we create a new one. OK, you give a name, and you can select size for the image. And then you can express your creativity now.
All right, let's draw another smiley.
OK. That's the best thing you can do, right?
Yes.
OK. OK, this is beautiful. Let's save it to Drive, because we want to store it for future generations.
Let's save.
OK.
To Drive.
OK.
There you go.
Yeah.
Extension, JPEG, PNG.
OK. So you have different extensions. You can save to different formats. OK.
The good thing is that it lets you know the approximate file size of the resulting image. So in case you're scared of running out of quota, you know before saving.
Oh, perfect. And of course, image editors know, with some file formats, you can select the quality so that you can make the file bigger or smaller, but you have a better or worse quality. So we've got this file in Google Drive, right? So we have new image. OK, this is working perfectly. But there is actually a scenario we found that is not perfect, and we wish Pixlr is going to fix it. So when you install an application from the Chrome Web Store, and this is the listing for Pixlr Editor, the application is added to the Chrome New Tab page, which is this. In the Chrome New Tab page, you get a link to all the applications you have installed, including those that integrate with Drive.
Yes.
So you can start Pixlr Editor from here. And you start it just by clicking. And it seems the same. Seems like the flow is exactly the same. But now you create a new image.
There you go.
You can select whatever you want here, as before. You can draw something.
All right.
This time is going to be sad.
OK. Why? Oh.
Because
we'll see why.
We'll see why. So then you try to save. And you want to save it to Drive. However, Drive is not included in the list of cloud destinations you can save to. So Pixlr behaves differently if you start from Drive or if you start from the Chrome Web Store.
Yes.
This is something that should be addressed for the best user experience, as the user should have the same features regardless of where they start from. This should be very easy to fix. I think it's just a small mistake. And we will definitely reach out to Pixlr. Maybe they're watching us right now. Please fix it, guys. OK.
One other thing is opening files from Pixlr.
OK, so another thing.
They have an option to open image, open mm-hmm. image via URL, mm-hmm. or open image library from
okay.
other cloud file system. Unfortunately, Drive is not one of the options.
That's another thing they can improve. This is, of course, it's not a bug, it's not an issue, but users might want to open a file directly from Drive. This can be done by using the Pixlr API, which is part of the Google Drive SDK, and so they can easily embed the Pixlr dialog in their application, or they might want to list files into this dialog, which they styled. So you have the two options. Using the Google-provided Pixlr is very easy, so you only need a couple of lines of JavaScript code, and you get it. But the dialog will have the UI we designed it for.
Yes.
While if you want to write that install it inside your application, you can basically draw that yourself. You have calls to list all the files on drive, and you can group them into folders and so on. You can do basically everything with the API, and then you can embed it into here.
That's correct.
So we got two feature requests for Pixlr from here. Use or embed a picker to open files directly from drive, and make sure that if the user starts from the Chrome new tab page or goes directly to Pixlr.com, the user should be allowed to save to drive.
That's correct.
But besides that, I must say the application is awesome.
Yes.
Even, I mean, OK, you're not you, but even average users like me, they can do great, crazy things with Pixlr. The application is very good. And obviously, one of the main advantages is that you can use that wherever you are, on the cloud.
On a Chromebook.
On a Chromebook, on whatever computer you are, just log in to your credential, well, to your account with your credentials, and you have Pixlr there. Yes.
You don't even need a desktop anymore, don't even need a hard drive, as all your files are stored in the cloud.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. So we said that we have two applications to talk about. Pixlr Editor is the advanced one. It has a lot of features. Really a lot. So you have so many filters and so many things you can do with Pixlr that a professional can use that and do a lot of very good image editing. Yeah. But if you're not a pro, let's say you're a LAN, you might want to use another application still by the same company, still by Pixlr, that is called Pixlr Express.
Let's open it.
Let's open it. So we open the same file, aren't we?
Yes, the original Titan from web.
Freewallpapersweb.com. So with this application, as you can see, the UI is really simplified. You have a limited number of features, still a lot, but limited compared to the Pro. Application that is the one we just talked about. And you can easily make changes to the image, applying some filters, you can crop image, you can resize them, you can apply some effects. Let's try one, let's see how your creativity goes now.
Wow.
Oh, you have black and white dark kittens. Okay, I think we can do better. For instance, one of the things I like, you can add borders to the image. Okay, this is getting okay. That's getting better and better. Another option is to add borders. So you have your photo, and you want to add a nice frame around it. So you can do it from here. And it's not gonna be great now because now everything is black and whitish. But you have a lot of very easy to use vintage kittens now. How do we get this application if you want?
From the Chrome Web Store.
Exactly the same thing. So we go to the Chrome Web Store, and we will find Pixlr Editor and Pixlr Express. We installed both. They have, as all the applications on the Web Store, they have a lot of reviews so that you can read about them before you install an application. Remember, reviews are by other users like you, so you should probably trust them and read them before you install any application. We installed it from here, and you can launch it from Google Drive, but you can also launch it from here. What happens if you launch the application from here?
Let's try this.
Let's see if it behaves like Pixlr Editor.
Well, obviously, we don't have any picture because we just opened the app from Chrome Web Store.
Okay, so we need to browse. And what we would expect, what we would like to get, is that you can open a file from Drive. So browse doesn't let you do that.
No.
With browse, you browse your local file system, which is another important feature. So that is not the case.
So you can open URL.
You can open a URL
from the web or use your webcam.
So this is a feature that Pixlr Editor doesn't have. So remember, these two applications are targeted at two different audiences. So with this very easy application, you can, let's say, fire up your webcam, take a photo, and apply some filters. So maybe you need to create your new profile photo. This might be the best application for you. You can do that in 10 seconds.
Yes.
And then you can get these very good special effects. Both applications are installed into Drive. So once you install them, you can right-click on any image file and open an existing file, or you can do create and then select either of those and start a new image. What are you trying to do now?
I'm saving the image.
Oh, okay. I want to see what happens now. So now we have many copies of these wallpaper we got from freewallpaperswap.com. And this is the latest version of it. This is amazing. It's probably your masterpiece.
So from Pixlr, you can only save a copy. Mm-hmm. From Pixlr Express, you can only save a copy.
Save and replace.
Oh.
Save and replace.
Missed that, sorry.
So yeah, as you can see, the UI is simplified compared to Pixlr Editor. So that instead of having a UI dialog for saving, you have two very specific buttons that say what they are going to do. So you have one to save and replace, because of course, you might want to replace the existing one. Or you can save a copy. And everything you said about saving a copy for Pixlr Editor applies. And of course, you can, I mean, the next button is to close it, and that's it. OK, let's just go back to Drive. And just to remind you before we wrap up, if you want to start any of those applications and you have no image files in your computer, you can do Create, select More, and you will find all the applications we have.
That's correct.
OK. OK, I think with that, we're basically done with Pixlr Editor and Pixlr Express, two great image editors that integrate with Drive.
Two feature requests?
Yeah, we have two feature requests for Pixlr Editor.
Yes.
And I'm pretty sure they're going to be fixed soon, because so far, these applications have been developed and adding new features very, very quickly.
And feature request for Pixlr Express integrate with the Pixlr API as well, so we can open an image from the application directly.
OK, last thing before we wrap up. If you are a developer and you want to integrate with the Google Drive SDK and you have technical questions, where do you go?
Stack Overflow under the tag google-drive-sdk. We go through the questions almost every day and try to reply to all of them.
Cool. OK, so see you next time on Google Developers Live. Thank you for joining us. And feel free to reach out to us for any feedback. Thank you.
Thank you.